Hi, today we'll talk about some animal interactions such as predation, mutualism, commensalism and parasitism. The first type of interaction is called as commensalism, where it's a relationship between two animals where one gets benefit and other is neither harmed nor benefited. As you can see in the smileys which are here, one is very very happy and smiling, the second one is neither harmed nor benefited. You can see there are clown fishes which are there, which are always seen in the tentacles of the sea anemones. The sea anemones have got stinging cells on their tentacles, which are called as nidocytes, and they attack, or rather they are a defense mechanism of the sea anemone. The clownfish has got a typical type of slimy coat on its body, which because of which it gets protection from the stinging cells of the sea anemone. They show commensalism. There is also an example wherein some of the insects which are stirred up are eaten up by the birds when the big mammals walk. You will also might have seen many a time that there are birds which are walking or taking a free ride on the back of large mammals. So whichever animals are stirred up from the grass while they are walking, these animals get a mouthful of them. One more example is attaching itself to another animal for transportation. You must have seen that larger animals such as whales have got barnacles on them and the clams on their tails, and they get a free ride. Also, you can see that a shrimp riding on sea slugs. By this way, they get free ride. Also, you can see that many a times there are hermit crabs which walk, and on the shells of the hermit crabs, there are a lot of sea animals which are attached to them. The sea animals are also moving around. There is second example, which is parasitism, where one animal is physically smaller than the other animal, and one animal, the parasite which is there, is benefiting, and the other one, which is the host, is always harmed. There are a lot of examples of parasites. One of them is ticks and fleas, which live, these are called as the ectoparasites. There are certain animals which are also called as endoparasites, such as the liver fluke which is there, the malarial parasite which are there. These are called as endoparasites, wherein the host is harmed, whereas the parasite is benefited. There are mosquitoes feeding on the host, and they are also parasites. You can see such as vines of kudzu trees growing on the trees. The tapeworms or hookworms living in the host gut, these are also parasites which are surviving inside the animals. They survive and they benefit out of the host. Next example is mutualism, where both the species are benefited from the interaction. Both the species are happy. Example is a hummingbird, where hummingbird is gathering nectar and it is spreading the pollen across. Also, there are honeybees which get honey from the flower and they help in pollination of the flowers. There are birds and mammals which eat berries and they fly across distances. There are mammals which eat berries, fruits. They move from one tree to another tree, and it helps or aids in the dispersal of the seed. There is one very very good example of the algae and the fungi which becomes a lichen, where algae gets the water and the nutrients from the fungus, and the fungus gets fruit from the algae by photo. There is a last example, which is predation, where one animal eats other animals. There are a lot of herbivores which are eating the plants, the carnivores which eat the animals. So the carnivores which are eating the animals are a best example of predation. You can see that a cat eating a mice or a rat. Also you can see lions predating on the mammals and eating the herbivores. Also hunting bears which are hunting the grizzlies which hunt the salmons when they come back. So this is all about predation, mutualism, commensalism and parasitism.